One Nation Under God. Freedom in its truest meaning is ordered under the direction of God and satisfies the human heart, directed under the order of creation. We who are given this gift have been established in the order of grace to choose between what is good and what is evil. A country that has distorted the meaning between good and evil distorts the meaning of true freedom. A country that compromises the dignity of life and human creation distorts the true essence of what it means to be free. We live according to the law of God, who is our ultimate freedom. He is our Creator, who gives life and breath to our very being. In our freedom, we as His children must live according to the law of God, who in His generosity has given mankind the ability to will what is good or to choose what is against His divine plan. The truest essence of freedom identifies man and brings him to a full reality of his existence as a being made in the image and likeness of the Creator who made the moon and the stars, and the land and nation for which man is given to nurture and care for in its fullest reality, has given man the will and intellect by order of grace to choose what is true and authentic or what is broken and distorted. When man in his identity is distorted by a false freedom, the order of grace becomes disordered and the true human liberty is run under the guise of a false god, the god of the flesh, world, and the devil. Truth bestows on man the ability and capacity to live according to what is good and right. A nation under the God of goodness restores to man this dignity of what is real and what is true. In our identity of what is good, man in his deepest essence comes to this truth when in his own being he encounters the dignity of man restored to his fullest essence. This dignity brings life and not destruction. This dignity respects the order of grace in man. This dignity realizes what is good and true by his union with his Creator and his own identity founded in his knowledge of what is good and what is evil. A nation that compromises the true meaning of freedom compromises the dignity of man, and the distortion of a society is inevitable. The true establishment of what is good comes forth from a nation that identifies man in his truest essence as beings that are made in the image and likeness of his Creator, who is the Father of all and the God of all. In this acknowledgement of his Creator, the nation then is governed by the God who created her, rather than a nation governed under man. When the authority of man is not rooted under the God of creation, then true freedom will not be fully established in that nation, but only more disorder and less unity among man. True freedom is founded in God alone, and is guarded by man through human virtue, ruled and governed by an authority higher than man. An authority that sacrifices life and brings dignity to the human person. It is safeguarded by a reality of what is good and what is true under the authority of God through man. We who are privileged to live under a nation under God must live this reality through the use of our human freedom in all truth and all goodness for the sake of dignity and the respect of all human life. Eternal Word of the Father, you have graced this nation with the presence of your most holy goodness by identifying in man a true freedom that respects the dignity of life and brings true justice in a nation that acknowledges the capacity of man towards the fullness of truth. In this freedom, we have distorted the meaning of life when the law of God is undermined and our roots founded in the reality of what is good is compromised by a false freedom. Refurbish the knowledge of your most holy presence in our nation, so that our laws may be redirected towards the law of God rather than under the law of man. Renew in our hearts the true meaning of what it is to live in a nation of ordered freedom, so that our culture may truly know what it is to live in a world that is safeguarded by justice and the fullness of truth. Reveal to us your most holy presence in this nation, so that your very existence in the hearts and minds you have given authority to rule may use their authority under the reality of what is truly good and what is truly beneficial in this nation created by you, O Most Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. May this nation be one as you are one, so that the truest meaning of freedom may reign in every heart and soul that is given the privilege to live on this land we call America. O Mother of the Americas, despise not our petition, but in your mercy hear and answer us. Amen.